Hi everyone, and welcome back. In this episode, we will be discussing the basic connection requirements for the MCU that we are using. When I say basic connection, I'm referring to the minimum pins and components that should be connected to make the MCU power up. All this information are available from the MCU's datasheet, which can be downloaded from its manufacturer. Now let's go ahead and open the technical specification for our microcontroller. What we are looking for is the information pertaining the minimum connection needed. Let's begin looking at the table of contents and see all the available sections. We can see a lot of sections about peripherals. We have timer, SPI, I2C. But what really caught my eye is section 2, which is guidelines for getting started with 16-bit microcontrollers. This is a pretty good place to start. Let's go ahead and click this one. We can see that in section 2.1, basic connection requirements, it covers the information that we are looking for. This is where we will begin reading. Now on the right side of the screen, we have figure 2-1, which illustrates the summary of the minimum connection we have to make for our MCU. Each symbol there has a label, like C2, C7, C3. And the label refers to a specific value below. Let's take for example R1 and R2. Referring to the keys below, we can see that R1 should have a value of 10 kilo ohms, while R2 should have a value in between 100 to 470 ohms. For the enclosed numbers 1 and 2, it refers to notes which can be found below. Let's go ahead and check what note 1 says. See section 2.4, voltage regulator pins, for explanation of ENV reg, this VREG pin connections. We have to go to this section to know the configuration of pins being referred above, which we are going to do later. Let's begin with the easier ones first. I'm gonna begin from the top left corner going counterclockwise. So first stop, we have the MCLR pin or the master clear pin. What this pin does is it resets the microcontroller. See the bar over the name? This tells us that this is an active low pin, which means that it issues a reset when it is pulled to the ground. If we don't want to experience unwanted reset, we need to pull it to VDD during normal operation. For this pin, we need to connect R1 and R2, which we have already mentioned earlier, and C1, which has a value of 0.1 microfarad ceramic capacitor. The next stop is the component between VSS VDD pins. An analog VSS VDD pins. Which refers to note 2, which says the example shown is for a PIC24 device with 5 VDD VSS and analog VSS pairs. Other devices may have more or less pairs. Adjust the number of decoupling capacitors appropriately. Sounds straightforward. Let's go ahead and check how many pairs of VDD VSS or analog VDD analog VSS pairs we have for our selected package. Let's go ahead and open the pin diagram of our selected package. We have here three different pin diagrams. Each pin diagram contains the information of a different package. Let's go on the last pin diagram. This diagram contains information regarding 44-pin QFN or 44-pin TQFP. On the second pin diagram, this refers to a 28-pin QFN. And in the first pin diagram, we have the pin diagram for a 28-pin SPDIP SOIC SSOP. This is the package that we are interested in and that we are using. So let's count how many pin pairs, how many VSS VDD pairs we have here. We have first pin 8 and pin 13, and we have the second one, pin 28 and pin 23. Let's go back to the previous section and check out the values for the component that we are going to attach to these pins. So you see that for C1 through C6, we are also going to attach a 0.1 microfarad 20 volt ceramic capacitor. Then we have VREG pin and VCAP VDD core pin, which has information on note 1, which says C section 2.4 for explanation of NVREG, these VREG pin connections. Let's go to that section by clicking the link right over here. Now it says here, the on-chip voltage regulator enable or disable pin must always be connected directly to either a supply voltage or to ground. The particular connection is determined by whether or not the regulator is to be used. For an NVREG pin, tie to VDD to enable regulator or to ground to disable the regulator. For this VREG pin, tie to ground to enable the regulator or to VDD to disable the regulator. For simplicity's sake, we are going to disable the regulator for now. So what we need to do is to determine if we have an NVREG or this VREG to know where we should be connecting to the pin. Let's go back to the pin schematic or the pin diagram and check out which pin is available for a selected package. So you can see here, in pin 19, we can see that we have a this VREG. So we are going to tie it directly to ground. Going back to section 2.4, let's skip the next paragraphs and proceed to the last paragraph, which details what to do when we have the regulator disabled. When the regulator is disabled, the VCAP or VDD core pin must be tied to a voltage supply at the VDD core level. Refer to section 29 for information on VDD and VDD core. So let's go to section 29 and see the information required for the specific pins. So we have here the absolute maximum ratings for the pin. This is not the information that we want. Let's scroll down. DC characteristics, temperature and voltage specifications. This is the table that we are interested in. So we have here VDD, VDD, VDD core. And then we have here conditions, regulator enabled, regulator disabled. We are setting up our regulator to be disabled. We can see that when the regulator is disabled, VDD is for VDD core to 3.6 and VDD core is from 2.0 to 2.75. So I guess it's safe to say that we can connect VDD core to VDD as long as it does not go beyond to 2.75. So I think that would be pretty much safe. In addition to the basic connection requirements, I'm also going to add an LED that I will be blinking for the bring up. Now that we have found the basic connection requirements for the MCU, the next step to do is to gather all the components, connect them together, and load our basic program, which will be a blinking program. In conclusion, this episode covered the basic connection requirements of a microcontroller and where to find them. Sometimes the pin's connection is straightforward, but other times, like the voltage regulator pin, it allows you to configure some particular function. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think, and see you on my next episode.